Hello, today we are going to show you how to report an internship in Orion for F1 master's students. To start, navigate to your Orion student profile and select My Academics. From there, we will go down and select Request Internship for Credit, and then Internship Questionnaire. Before completing the internship questionnaire, be sure you review the information above. If you have questions regarding how many hours you can work for each credit, you may select this link. If you have questions regarding reporting dates and timelines, you may select this link. If you have any other questions, you can select this link to go to the JSOM CMC Answer Center. To start, you will select the program to which the internship will apply. For this example, we are going to select accounting. You will then select what type of internship this will be. F1 students must select internship. If you are a domestic student that is already employed, you can select full-time job. For this example, we are going to select internship. If approved, I authorize to be registered for how many credit? We're going to select 2 credit hours. You will then choose when you are graduating. For this example, we're going to say December 17th. You will then select a semester in which the internship will be. We are going to select Fall 2021. You will then select Create New Request. On this page, you will upload your job description and your offer letter. We will start with a job description. In this box, we will put job description. For the comments, in this example, we will say, this is my job description. You are permitted to put whatever information you feel is necessary. We will then add the document, select my device, and upload your job description. Select done, and then submit. We will select OK, and then do the same thing for our offer letter. We'll provide the necessary information. Again, you can provide whatever information you feel is necessary. Select Add, select My Device, and provide your offer letter. You will select Done, and then Submit. After you're done uploading your supporting documentation, we can continue to internship questions. We'll start with the first question, the job title. What is the job title for your internship? We are going to select Accounting Intern. Next question. Company name. What is the employer's name as shown on your offer letter? For this example, I'm going to copy and paste Best Company LLC in the example. You must provide the employer's name that is shown on your offer letter. Next question. What will your expected salary be? For this example, I'm going to put $15 per hour. Next question. What is the start date of the internship? We are going to provide a start date of August 16th. Next question. What will the internship end date be? We are going to provide an end date of December 10th. Next question. Indicate the number of hours to be worked per week. This cannot be a range. If more than 40 hours per week, select 40 plus. International students that are working 21 hours or more are considered full-time. International students that are working 20 hours or less are considered part-time. For this example, we are going to select 40. Next question. What are the total number of hours you expect to have worked by the end of this internship? We're going to select a range from the drop-down menu. We will select 300 or over. Next question. What is your employer's street address? Include the street number, the street name, the suite number, the city, state, and the zip code. For this example, we are going to copy and paste the information provided. You will copy the information provided in your offer letter. Next question. What is the physical work address? Is your physical work location the same as your employer address? If yes, please type yes. If not, please give your work location street address. If assigned by your employer to a client location, please include the company name. For this, we are going to say yes, because our physical work location is the same as the employer address. Next question. Supervisor contact information. Please provide your supervisor's contact information. If not assigned a supervisor yet, please enter your recruiter contact information. For this example, we are going to copy and paste the provided information. Again, you will provide the information offered in your offer letter. Next question. ISSO authorization. In order for CPT authorization to be approved, the ISSO must update your I-20 record. Do you give the ISSO permission to update your I-20 record? If you answer no, your CPT request will not be processed. F1 international students will need to answer yes. Next question. Social Security number. Will you be applying for a Social Security number? We are going to select yes for this example. Next question. Reduced course load. Will you be requesting an exception for reduced course enrollment? If you have questions regarding reduced enrollment, please refer to the ISSO's guide or ask questions on their website. We're going to select no for reduced course load. Next question. Internship alignment with coursework. Federal regulation permits F1 non-immigrant students to apply for authorization to engage in training that is directly related to their major area of study. Please explain how this internship employment relates to your coursework. For this example, we're going to copy and paste this information here. I have stated we are using this box to explain how this internship employment relates to your coursework. Please provide the necessary information. Next question. In addition, list at least one course and course number that you have completed or are completing this semester that is directly relevant to your internship. For this, I'm going to put ACCT 6100 because I believe that that course is relevant to my internship. Next question. I understand that by accepting this offer verbally or by email that I have made a commitment to this employer for the time frame listed in the offer. I also understand that if I renege or back out of the commitment on this internship that there are consequences which will result in failure of the internship CPT course. However, if there are concerns with the employer, experience, or type of work, please discuss with the CMC or your program director before making a decision. We are going to select yes. Next question. I agree to cease the pursuit of additional internship opportunities for this semester, including emails, phone calls, and interviews. We are going to select yes. Next question. Internship course enrollment. I understand that if my internship is approved, I will be enrolled in the internship course for the number of credit hours approved or the number of hours I requested, whichever is smaller. Tuition fees must be paid for credit hours. We are going to select yes. Late fees. I understand if I am approved, I'll be enrolled in either the full term session or the second 5 or 8 week session. If I choose to be enrolled into a session that requires paying a late fee, I must notify advising. We are going to select yes. I understand that I cannot change the number of credit hours for my internship course once registration has been completed. We are going to select yes. Next question. Internship course assignments. I understand that the internship course includes assignments which must be completed by the due date. We are going to select yes. Next question. Maintaining the GPA requirement. I understand that if my GPA falls below 3.0 after the internship has been approved, that my internship may be terminated. We are going to select yes. Next question. The CPT workshop requirement. I understand that because I am on an F1 visa status, I must complete a CPT workshop prior to ISSO approval for working in the US. I confirm that I have done this. Note, if you have not completed the CPT workshop, please save your work and complete the online workshop before submitting this request. You can select this link, how to complete the workshop. We're going to select yes. Next question. Do not start your work authorization without a valid I-20. I understand that I cannot start work until CPT has been approved and the I-20 has been issued. The start date is at least 7 business days from now, allowing sufficient processing time. If not, I must contact the employer to agree to a later start date. The CPT request will be submitted after you are confirmed to be enrolled in the internship course. We are going to select yes. Next question. Before you submit. If you have skipped a question, you will be unable to submit. Also, check that the answers are in the format requested. When all questions have been answered, you will see the submit button. Once you submit your request, you will be unable to make changes to the survey answers. UCC will be able to make changes for you. You may receive requests to add more information or documents. Please respond promptly to any requests. We are going to select yes. At this point in the survey, we are going to say save progress. You have completed the request questions. Please review your answers and click the submit button. We're going to select OK. We can now see the submit internship request button. We're going to select that. Are you sure you want to submit your internship request? We are going to say yes. We have now submitted our internship request. This has been how to report an internship in Orion for F1 master students. If you have any questions, please chat with us online at the link provided or find answers to questions at JSOM CMC Answer Center, also at the link provided. Or you can email us at jindal.career@utdallas.edu. Thank you.